If and when they decide to introduce this bill, there will be at least 1,000 people at the Capitol.
Phil Silberman is warning Colorado lawmakers tonight, if they introduce a bill to make it harder to not vaccinate your kids, be prepared for massive opposition. Silberman, one of the many Coloradans raising his 14-year-old daughter vaccine free.
And she is very, very healthy. We came to the conclusion that we were not going to vaccinate.
Tonight at the Capitol, though,
we're one of the easiest places in the nation to really exempt out of vaccines or immunizations.
Representative Kyle Mullica, whose day job is an ER nurse, doesn't seem fazed, telling us he wants a new vaccine bill introduced in the coming weeks. Right now, parents don't have to vaccinate if they claim one of these exemptions. There's a medical exemption, a religious exemption, and a personal belief exemption. Mullica is discussing taking away the personal belief exemption, telling us Colorado must do something about what he calls a public health crisis of being dead last in the U.S. for having kindergartners vaccinated.
I was surprised to learn that there's 49 states that report, and we're 49th. We want our students to be able to go to school and be safe.
The vaccine debate is one of the hottest topics in the medical community, with most health professionals encouraging immunizations. But that doesn't mean the bill will pass.
This is a parents' rights issue.
Republican House Leader Patrick Neville says conservatives will fight this, and Neville believes Democratic Governor Jared Polis is on his side. Representative Mullica confirming to us the governor may oppose his bill.
We probably have some disagreements with the governor on this.
Regardless, get ready, Colorado. A vaccination debate is on the horizon. Phil, ready for the fight.
This is about defending freedom.
Again, the bill not expected to be introduced until sometime in mid-March. We have learned from the representative that this will not impact homeschooled children. But keep an eye on Governor Polis on this. He told The Hill TV in the last 24 hours, when government tries to force parents to do this, it creates distrust in both vaccinations and distrust in government. So keep an eye on the governor. We'll keep an eye on this bill. Live at the Capitol, Joe St. George, Fox 31.